In the last weeks, we have learned a lot about the gratings. Today, I will introduce you to the calibration of a Raman spectrometer.
Of course, all of you remember that the grating disperses Raman scattered light on the CCD, which turns into a spectrum. But to interpret the spectrum, we need to know the wavelength of Raman signal on each CCD pixel. This is called Xaxis calibration. The most popular way to do this is to measure a calibration lamp, for instance, a neon-argon or mercury lamp, to see how the spectrometer disperses the atomic spectral lines. These spectral lines are very precise in wavelength and the peaks are also sharp. From the measurement of the calibration lamp, we can easily calibrate the x-axis of the Raman spectra. Unfortunately, calibration of the spectrometer is not something can be done once and for all. The construction of dispersive Raman spectrometer makes the calibration vulnerable to many factors. An important source of error is a grating turret. If you turn the turret to a different angle and turn it back again, the positioning is inevitably slightly different. Due to the long path length to the CCD, the difference is even amplified. To compensate this, a regular recalibration of the spectrometer, especially after a change of grating, is highly advisable. Some experiments fundamentally rely on good calibrations. Take the monitoring of the stress in silicon wafer, for example. 100 megapascal stress only causes a 0.2 wave number shift of the Raman peak. A 1 wave number error in this case would lead to a 500 megapascal error in the measurement. But there are other examples as well. In the statistical study of Raman spectra, drift of calibration can cause critical artifacts in the model. For such very sensitive experiments, calibration of the Raman spectrometer must be planned ahead carefully and wisely.
If you watched all previous episodes, you are clearly not a beginner anymore. In the upcoming final episodes, I will share several stories about how Raman spectroscopy helps scientists in their research.